All right, decided to do a voiceover on this. Just kind of explain us unloading this engine that I bought and how I do it without a forklift. Nice thing is, work for a rental company, you get a nice trailer you can borrow. So here we are unstrapping it. And trailer's too wide to really get into the shop, so we just got the tail end over the back. Gonna get the engine hoist underneath of it and get it hoisted out of there. So this is a 6-horse lister. It's pretty heavy, so we just used a heavy duty ratchet strap to suck it on back. Here's my son helping us out. It's good to have him out there. He's a big help and he has fun, so he's my little tractor show buddy. And here we are, just using the ratchet strap. Couldn't find the come along, so use what we have. We tried dragging it back, but it's pretty dang heavy. Got my boy there supervising us, so he said we're doing a good job. Yeah, like I said, it's a heavy son of a gun. I'm not sure the weight on a 6-horse lister, but it's up there. So here are getting the chain on, getting it ready to get hoisted. It's pretty much a two-man job. I've done it by myself before with that 6-horse stover in the back several times. And it's not a lot of fun, but kind of fighting a ledge right there on the shop floor. The engine hoist has to go over it, so it's quite difficult. You'll see me snagging right there. This is where it's kind of funny. I ended up bending my pry bar trying to get it over that hump. So it's nice having my buddy here helping me. He just dropped in and he helped me out, which is nice. So here's the funny part. I wanted to rip into this thing and clean it all up, but it's not seized. Let's see if we can get the start on some ether. So I had the bright idea to use my stover that's governed way too slow, to try to spin this thing over to see if we could get this lister to fire off. I had a lot of trouble trying to get the belt straight, trying to get it tight. Everything was the wrong direction. If I would have put a twist in it, I would have made things a lot easier. But you'll see coming up here that the belt to fly off, and trying to keep the stover running wasn't easy. The governor kept slowing down, so I need to work on that thing. We're going to a show next weekend, so need to get that done this week. So we're just oiling it up, just kind of getting it ready and giving it a quick start, and I'll have a non-fast-forwarded video coming up. But my camera started to die, so this is why this next clip's so short. Yeah, sorry the last clip was so short. My GoPro ended up dying, so that's all you get. But we ended up doing that for a whole nother hour, trying to get the engine straight, and the belt kept flying off. But it was fun, lack of experience, and just learning. Couldn't really keep the stover running very well, because the governor is, I have it made to run really slow. So, as you can see in the picture here, we don't have the fuel lines on, so we were trying to start it with some ether, and this thing is pretty hard to turn over. So we ended up finding out that the
valve timing was a little off. And if you see up there the rocker arms at the top of the picture, there's some adjustment screws for the push rods, and they're seized up. So I wasn't going to get into that. I just kind of left it as it is. And yeah, so we didn't get it started. But I'll make a whole nother video on it actually running, getting it running. So that'll be fun. But long story short, this engine I bought at auction here in Western Kansas, and it actually came from Mexico. I called the guy that brought this to the auction, and he's a German Mennonite that lived down there, grew up down there, and he took this off a farm next to his dad's farm, and it ran a generator there. There's a tag you will see in the pictures coming up that's in all in Spanish. It's actually an instruction tag. I thought that was pretty cool. So any Lister guys on here that know quite a bit about these, there'll also be another picture with the serial number and RPMs and the model and all that stuff. So if you have any info on this, it'd be awesome to leave it down in the comments. And then two, if anybody knows, like, if there was any dealers in Mexico that were Lister dealers back in the 30s, any literature on that, I'd love to see it. It'd be cool to have with this engine. You know, it made a journey from England to Mexico and now in Western Kansas. So I appreciate you guys watching. Like I said, there'll be some pictures coming up here shortly with the picture of the stover, obviously, and then all the tags that are on the engine. And if you have any info, please leave in the comments. Appreciate you watching.